everyone. It is Sunday, fourth week of Jingle Week. I'm on my way to my lash appointment today. And then later, I have to do some errands in Virginia. And one of them is Kirtland's because it's only located in Virginia. So I just saved all my Virginia errands for so I can do them all in one lump. My lash esthetician, Karen, is located in Virginia, so that's why. Anyways, and then later today, I'm gonna clean up the place a little bit, and then start prepping for my potluck dish that I'm gonna bring for tonight's potluck slash game night, so that should be fun.
Look at her cute little Christmas tree. It's an ornament tree, I love it.
So just to show you guys my current lashes right now, this is probably at 3-4 weeks. This is actually 4 weeks. And I'm trying to take care of them pretty nicely so that I don't, in case I can't get to a 3 week, I can do a 4 week. But they're still not too bad. I'm gonna just get them more plump and I'll show you guys the after. Meet my lash girl, Karen! We just realized that it's been 2 years since I've been coming to her.
Oh, happy anniversary!
Hi guys, this is Karen. I'm taking over. I'm just gonna show you what I did on Melanie's pretty lashes, nice and fluffy. These are the volume extensions in 0.7, probably from 12 millimeter all the way to 8 to give her more of a natural cat eye look. She wants something longer towards the end and tapers down towards the inner part. From this angle and open big for me, Melanie. Awesome. There you go. No clumpies.
All right, guys. I am fully lash on, but look how fluffy they look now. So much fuller. I absolutely love the volume technique that Karen's put on me. It just makes everything look so nice and very flirtatious. I'm holiday ready, guys. Okay, so I just got into my car and it's freaking raining. Of course, I mean, I knew that today, but it's 68 degrees, which I'm not complaining. And guess what? Karen had that Christmas tree up, which was so cute. It was like an ornamented Christmas tree. And one of them was this cute little top hat. Oh my gosh. I already shot Dex's Christmas photo shoot, which was so cute. But I'm going to reshoot it and using this hat. It's like a little clip though. So I'm going to see how it will fit on his head. But it's so cute. So I was like, oh my gosh, she had three of these. I was like, Karen, can I have one of them for Dex's photo shoot? So I'm so excited to put this together. All right, it's raining. I was gonna get my favorite Rice Krispie treat from McAllister's Deli, but now I can't because it's closed. I didn't know they closed on Sundays. So I'm gonna go to Kirkland's to return my stuff, Target to return stuff, West Elm to return stuff. So it's a lot of returning stuff today. So, all right. All right, I just got to Dulles Town Center, which is like a mall here, but it's the one of the locations that has Kirkland's. So I'm gonna return some stuff, but whew, the temperature just dropped like 20 degrees. It's freezing now. What the heck is wrong with this weather? So I'm on my way to West Elm and still feeling super annoyed with Kirkland's policy, and they're not the only ones too, but so far there's other places that perfectly accepts PayPal returns, such as Sephora, Nordstrom, whatever. There's like a ton of places, but Kirkland's one that won't accept returns if you pay by PayPal online, and then Urban Outfitters is also another place that they don't accept returns if you PayPal, like if you use PayPal online. Not that they don't accept returns, but they have to refund it but on a gift card, and I just don't want a gift card. I don't shop at Kirkland's that often to use a gift card. So I'm about to do the crab mac and cheese, and Dexie's going to help me. Right, Dex and Rini? So the elbows are already in the water to boil for al dente. And then I'm gonna prep the rest of the ingredients. All right, so mac and cheese done. I just have to take it over to my friend's place and put it in the oven for about like 10 minutes so it can brown at the top and melt. I my oven is very finicky. It's like it runs really, really hot. So I can't put this in. I mean, I can, but I don't want to risk it. I don't want to like burn it. And I'm going to take Dexy with me too. So, all right, we're going to head on out. Also bringing guacamole. So we're preparing that too for the potluck.
Ho, ho, ho!
Santa in the house!
It all diverted. It was annoying. My friend coming from San Francisco was supposed to get in at,
my mac and cheese is in the oven. The game night going down. I brought Mahjong too, just in case people want to play. Do you want some food? No, don't eat some food. Hi, baby. Do you miss me? Huh? You miss me?
I walk into the garage.
Brought Dexy with me into the pot tent.
I walk into the garage and I'm like, oh my.
Hi. He's having fun, right? Hey everyone, so I am in DC waiting on my blogger friends to come for lunch, but in the meantime I'm actually meeting another friend of mine who's a fashion blogger that we're gonna do some photo shoots prior to the lunch. So I'm just waiting for her to park and then we can get out and shoot.
A little bit of both.
So I'm here at Fig and Olive in City Center with my fashion
beauties.
And we're just gonna get ready to eat. We ordered the burrata and the paella del mar
and shit. It's like a little bit of everything. And right now, working, doing my master's and vlogging is a lot.
Oh my goodness.
It's a lot.
So the paella came and it's like so tiny.
See, that's the other thing. I haven't decided.
I'm surprised about this.
If I even want to keep my Snapchat, because
my friends,
I do, I have like more followers on Instagram.
Right,
and doing
do
both is so much.
Yes, getting my soft serve, milk soft serve. It's super, super good.
Oh, really?
The zero milk soft serve in this place is super, super good. And I always add the crunch to it. They also have an avocado version with coffee and the zero milk soft serve. This is so good. Getting ready to dig in. Ooh, yummy. Show us this one.
So good.
Hey guys. So today's just been a light day. I've just been working on the blog and some YouTube stuff, but I've been waiting for this package to come all day. It was supposed to come between 1 and 5, and I actually didn't receive it until I think it's 6:45. So I was gonna wait until the package come and then head out to run some errands. But anyways, I'm excited to show you guys what I got. I've been debating whether or not to go to Target in another location so I can get these wrapping papers, the craft wrapping papers, so I can wrap these boxes. They're just like display boxes so I can put underneath the Christmas tree, which I actually got these, I didn't show you from the other day, but they're like light lit Christmas presents that were super cheap at Kirkland's. I believe total was like $13 for the both of them. I didn't light them up yet because I'm gonna wait until I get like a longer extension cord to do that, but I wanted to put prop Christmas gifts underneath because I'm not doing any gifts this year just because I'm like on a, you know, semi spending freeze. So yeah, I am gonna go and make myself some hot chocolate and then just kind of keep warm from the cold. Okay, a few things came from my meme box, which I got this Skin Lab Glacial Clay Facial Mask, this body jelly wash in the milk flavor, this Manyo Factory Skin Brightening Cream, and then Donkey Milk Skin Gel Mask Brightening. I'm excited to try them out and see what the results are. And of course, my cocoa. Okay, so I got the Canon PowerShot G7X Mark II. One of the features that sold me was the 24mm wide on this, and it can go up to like 4.2x zoom, which I think is like 128mm. And of course, the f1.8 is typically what I look for a blurry background, and the Wi-Fi capable function so that I can upload automatically to my either my phone or my laptop without having to connect or import the photos. So that's what sold me, and then I'm gonna sell my Canon T4i so I could keep this. And I like that it's a point and shoot that I can take with me and that I'm able to use the autofocus on it as well. All right, We're testing this on Dexaruni. The GX7 Canon. Look at him. So cute. He's trying to get out of his. Oh. So this is a very quick, easy snack, fried plantains. It will go on my food channel, so be sure to subscribe so you can see how to make these super easy snacks. Hey everyone, so I'm on my way to Target at a different location that's about like 15-20 minutes away, only because the craft paper that I was looking for is sold out near me, the two Targets near me, so I'm just gonna go and get that so I can come back and wrap some display boxes. Since I'm opting out of gifts this year, I want to at least have some gifts to show underneath the tree to make it lively. I know there's only like a few days left of Christmas, but it's just the little things, and I can use it for next year too. And then some more errands after I meet up with my friend for lunch. So I will bring you guys along with my day. It's still been pretty busy. Yesterday I really didn't do much, but as you can see, the last night's clip and this clip is shot with the Canon G7X Mark II. So I'm actually going to sell my T4i only because I feel like this can probably do a lot of what I'm looking for without having to get a bigger camera or like a DSLR camera to film or record videos. Because for one, the f-stop is at f1.8, which gives you that blurry background, and two, it has manual options, so you can adjust lighting and whatnot, and also it shoots in RAW as well. So there's a lot of functions on here and a little point and shoot. And I've been looking for something like a point and shoot that I can take with me without having to take my big camera, because I have a the 5D Mark III at home, which I do use professionally for photography, for like wedding photography. So I don't want to carry that around because that thing is like freaking you know, just to lug it around is like so heavy. So it's nice to have this point and shoot. I like that the display you can pop up from the back, so that I can see, you know, what I'm recording to make sure that I'm actually in frame. So there's a lot of pluses with this camera, so I decided to get it, and then I'm going to sell the T4i to make up for the difference in the cost. So, and another thing I wanted to mention, which I forgot, another feature of this camera is that obviously the autofocus on it is awesome. For the T4i that I was using, I couldn't even do the autofocus because it would get so noisy, and it kept trying to change focus quite often, that would just like, it'll have that dizzying effect. I ended up turning it off anyway, so that function was not good. But on this one, the autofocus is very smooth, and it does it automatically, which I love. That was definitely a great plus in purchasing this camera. Okay, so here it is, all the presents wrapped, and under the tree, these are really just displays, but yeah. And then the other two presents here on the side is from Kirkland's. They were really inexpensive. Okay, so I'm on my way to meet my friend for late lunch, actually, since she pushed it from 1 to 2. And then I wanted to actually stop by this dessert place beforehand and see if I could, but it's a vegan place and it had the most delicious cookie there, and I want to see like what else they have, so definitely going to check it out, and it's in the same area. So we're at this Sticky Fingers Sweets and Eats. It says vegan sweets for everyone, so we're walking in. Alright, so I just picked up two things, blueberry muffin and a chocolate chip cookie. So hopefully it'll be good. I know I had the cookie before, so that was good, but the blueberry muffin I haven't yet. Now I'm going to meet my friend at room 11, which is one of my favorite place to get desserts there. Well, also the food there is not too bad too. So I haven't seen her in a while, but she switches back and forth between here, DC, and Barcelona. Her family's in Barcelona, so she's here for Christmas break. So I want to see her before she goes back. So my friend just got here, and look at this lovely latte art.
Because it's
here is the basilica in the daytime. I know every time I come here, it's always at night. This thing is massive. I want to see if I actually can go in to show you guys the Christmas decor. Let's see if it's open actually. Each country has its own little section and it's decorated in its own holiday decor. This one is from Poland. So that is the quick tour of the National Basilica behind us. And there's also the bottom level that is really nice to go in and visit if you're ever in the city. I would totally recommend coming here. But yeah, if you guys are ever in the area, definitely come here to visit. It's highly, highly recommended. There's just so many different sections of this basilica to take a look at. All right, so we're at this restaurant Nido, which is awesome, in this little small town in DC, and I love the decor here. The owner makes the lights and all like the decor around here, which is awesome. The pan roasted mushrooms. The clam linguine looks so good.
I've already got two. Go for it, man.
Chocolate ganache tart with mint ice cream and hazelnut ice cream coming soon. Hey everyone, so I am going to the mall this late because my sister asked me to pick up something for my dad. I got a freaking ticket. I'm so annoyed. Because I think I moved here, what, since July? And I parked here before. I never had a ticket. But then again, I also didn't park throughout the day, so I guess I was lucky. So I got a ticket, it's like $60. It's a pain in the ass. Not something that I need right now. Now I'm heading to the mall to help my sister get a gift for my dad because she's not sure which like leather jacket to get. And she doesn't want to get the wrong one. So I'm going there. I mean, I felt like she could have at least told me, you know, at least a week early because it's what, 2 days before Christmas. But I can't blame her. She has three kids, you know. So being a good sister I am, I'm on my way to the mall. Now, I just caught a Santa Pikachu. So that kind of helped lighten the parking ticket situation because I think I wouldn't have caught it if I didn't circle back to get it. Okay, at the mall, heading to look for some item for my dad. And I just realized that I can probably go and fight the ticket because I don't have a job, so I can just go on my free time and see if they could at least lower the cost of the ticket was like $60. So let's see. So it's my only time out right now, only because I was filming a holiday hair tutorial. Hopefully coming soon. I kind of wanted to like redo some of the hairstyle for tomorrow. So that's probably what I'll do in the morning. But yeah, I think I'm gonna call this a night, and nothing exciting right now except for the stupid parking ticket. But bye, tomorrow. Bye. Good morning, guys. Welcome to my bathroom. This part of the area hasn't been renovated yet because I'm gonna wait until I have more funds so I can make this into my little spa heaven. But right now, I am going to put on this mask that I've been wanting to do for the past 2 weeks, but every time it's like at night, like really late at night, I don't want to do it. So I guess I'll do this in the morning. So let's get to it. So this is Biosaz detoxifier mask with squalane in it. This is the one that Wendy has raved about, so I wanted to check it out. But it comes with two items here, one and two, that you pour into a bowl, which I have here. I'm gonna go ahead and mix it in and show you guys what it looks like. Okay, so I've mixed it up for 30 seconds. The instruction says to do that. Essence one is the blue color, and number two is the clear gel. One is a detoxifying gel, and the two is the moisturizing base. So now I'm gonna apply this to my face. It's on a clean face, I just washed it. Feel like a little tingly sensation. So now it says for optimal absorption of actives into the skin, leave on for 15 to 20 minutes, and then you peel off in one piece. For best results, use weekly. So now I'm gonna wait until it hardens up, or so I can peel it off. Maybe I should apply like a thicker layer, so it makes it easy to peel. All right, I'm gonna finish doing this and then I'll come back. Okay, now that my face is applied, I can join the Blue Man group now. Yay! At first, when I applied it, I felt like a very tingly sensation. Now I have to sneeze. Ugh, hate when that happens. And applied the rest of it to my face, and I already felt that it was hardening. I was using the brush in the beginning, which I guess helped a little bit, but actually it's better just to use your hands, just like the best tools ever, because it kind of like helps even out the mask around my face. So I'm gonna let this on for about 15-20 minutes, and I'm going to come back and show you guys as I peel it off my face and what's the result after that. All right, guys. Okay, so I went to open up my sister's holiday card. She sends one every year, and I place it on my refrigerator. And then they are the cutest. Look at them. Ty, this one's Ty, looks like his dad. Quinny looks like her mom. And then Eli is the youngest. Super adorable. And they also sent Ty's school photo. What a handsome guy. And then on my refrigerator magnets, these are actually all the magnets that I collected through traveling to Europe and different places. I thought that I would want to get magnets to fill up the fridge, but I'm actually thinking that would be a lot of magnets because I do want to travel some more. So I decided to just, instead of collecting magnets, I'll just collect ornaments for my tree. So each one I would have to go along with the theme, because I went with like a white and gold theme. But I thought that would be awesome just to collect ornaments that I can place on the tree. So that is my next plan. Also, I got this acne pimple master patch, because I'm kind of sick and tired of seeing that pimple on the side of my face. So I want to see if this would work. But it's just like a tiny patch you put over it, and I guess you just sleep. I'm gonna try to remember to use it tonight. 2 days before Christmas, guys. So I think it's been about 15-20 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and peel this off. It makes my skin feel really smooth. I still have like bits and pieces I need to remove in the shower, so I'm gonna be back. All right, so I'm making myself an omelet because I had all these veggies from leftover when I made that ratatouille slow cooker stew, which didn't turn out well. So, but I had a lot of extras, so I'm putting it into this omelet. Now making the base of it. The stir fry is done. Looks very yummy. I actually added sriracha in it too. So making the base, and I'm gonna add a little bit of this cheddar cheese that I still have left over from last time making the crab mac and cheese. So, okay, so the filling is added, and I put a little bit of cheese on the bottom to have it stick well, as well as a little bit at the top, and I'm gonna fold this over. And my omelet breakfast is done. If I had this much time to do this in the morning, I would. It makes it easy to have a healthy breakfast, but I added green peppers, red peppers, yellow peppers, jalapenos, tomatoes, and mushrooms. And then I had a little bit of sriracha in the sauce as well. And then just like, you know, the cheddar cheese to combine the two. And it was like three eggs. So yep, I'm digging in. All right, so I just got done some holiday hair tutorial coming soon to the channel. So be sure to check it out. I'm also having some nachos and then watching Friends while I edit this video so I can have it ready for you guys before Christmas. There is just way too many people on the streets right now. Everyone's scrambling to get their holiday shopping, and it's just a lot of cars, and everybody's trying to find parking. But yeah, fun stuff, huh? All right, I'm gonna shut off and drive to Anthropology. This is super cute. My cup of tea. Just got done from Anthropology. That teapot was really cute, so I did get that one. I don't typically shop there as much though, because a lot of the items there is really expensive, but that teapot was really cute. Look at this, love this dress. All right, just got home, have Friends on. And I'm just about to also go on Amazon because I'm actually trying to find a headdress for New Year's Eve's Gatsby theme. So going to do that while working on this as well. Hey everyone, I am on my way to Philly. Started late coming out because I don't know, it's just like, I think I'm like coming down with a cold or something. So my nose kept running. So I had a late start, and I was cuddling in bed with Dex. He was always sleeping, so it's easy to do that. I took him with me too, so he's like right there. Hello, Fauna. My sister is not gonna be home until like Sunday night, so I won't see the babies until then. Oh, and my second sister, she's pregnant, so that's exciting news. She's been trying, and we're also very excited for her. So we're waiting for a new bundle of joy coming soon in June, so that's exciting. In the meantime, I get to play with my other sister's babies. She has three of them. One's like six, really, but and the other two is like, the other is three, and then almost two. So cute. Okay, so I'm gonna focus on driving and then catch up in a little bit. Bye.
Hi, thank you for choosing Starbucks. I'll be with you in one moment.
Okay. So funny, so I stopped and got some refreshment for the road, and the lady behind the counter was like, is that a hamster? Because she saw my cage in the passenger seat, and I was like, no, it's my hedgehog. And she was like, what, shut up. So she wanted to see it, and I pulled Dex out for her. It's super cute, and she was like, oh my gosh, he is of course cute. So he's like down here chilling, want to get out. I'm just halfway to my parents' home. I should be there like by around 6 or something. All right, just got home. My dad loves to decorate this place. Looks like something's new on here. How cute. I'm gonna go get Dexy. So we're at this like Japanese restaurant with my sister. I'm gonna keep her privacy, not show her. I think I'm gonna go with the spicy seafood udon since I feel like I'm gonna have a cold coming on, so that might be good. Here is my spicy seafood udon. And then my sister got the tempura with an extra on the side. Alright, so we just got home, laying in bed, watching Home Alone for Christmas. We were wanted to watch How the Grinch Stole Christmas, but it wasn't in any of the streaming softwares. And Dex is here cuddling with me. Hi, Dexie. Alright. Calling it a night. See you tomorrow. Starting my Christmas day, having summer rolls for lunch. This is what we do in the Asian family. Here's my family's Christmas tree.
Where?
So that's my sister Linda. It is much fuller than mine, but I like mine because it's like not too big around my place. This would probably be too much. It's like 7.5 feet. And then of course we have a large family: 3 sisters, 1 brother, plus a ton of relatives, and then 2 nephews and 1 niece, and then 1's on along the way. So there's a ton of gifts for them too. And obviously my sister loves, or my family loves to have train track around the Christmas tree.
They're all heinous pictures.
So my sister decided to do a collage of my brother-in-law in his Christmas gift. Look at this, this is amazing. It's upside down, Linda.
No,
oh yeah, that's true. Look at that. So cute. I've never seen something like this before.
It's called Christmas collage wrapping paper.
Oh my gosh. I am like super sick. I hope I get better before the babies come. I want to squeeze them and hug. Good morning, everyone. I am pretty sick. I think I've like blown my nose how many times already for the past 2 days. It probably doesn't look red because I kind of concealed it. Anyways, I am borrowing my dad's car. He told me to get some salad on Christmas Day, so I need to go to this Korean mart since they're open till 7. Yay for Asians. So I'm gonna head over there and then get some salad, come back. I'm like super sick. I don't even feel like going out, but I got out anyways because my dad is always out and about. So he already washed my sister's car and he's in the middle of washing my car, so I might as well do something good too. I'm at the Korean market Asi. I think that's how you say it. But they don't have salad here. So I'm just gonna get myself a bubble tea and then head home. I am just feeling so sick. My nose is so stuffed. So yeah. I should have gotten, I got the rose black milk tea, but I think I should have gotten it cold instead of hot because they put it in this plastic thing. And it's not really good to drink it out of a plastic, but I guess this will do. I drove by and I saw CUS is open, so I'm gonna go and get some cold medicine. So I'm in a small town and to the left, let's do a little tour, shall we? It used to be my high school and it's no longer there. They tore it down a couple of years ago to build developments. So it's a very small town outside Philadelphia. So I got my medicine and I actually was able to use that dollar coupon, which is good because it was for like any Tylenol cold medicine. I'm gonna go home, take the medicine, cuddle with Dex for a little bit because I brought him home with me. And wait for my sisters to come home. Alright, you can't see this, but we are watching The Grinch Stole Christmas, or How the Grinch Stole Christmas with Jim Carrey. One of Christmas classics. Christmas dinner in an Asian household. Hot pot, chicken, I don't know what that is. Pot roast? Oh my god.